What's this?
These equations are linear, but there are three of them, and there are three variables. I know how to handle systems of equations when there are just two equations and two variables, but here we've got three. I don't have any special strategies for that, so you know what? I'm just going to try the same thing I did with systems of two linear equations and see if that works. And those strategies were substitution and elimination. Now, substitution here, I mean, it might work, but we'll be substituting huge expressions into two other equations, and it sounds like a lot of work. I'd like to do less work, so I'm going to try elimination. I'm going to try elimination because I kind of like that a little bit better, but which variable should I eliminate? Well, it looks easiest to me, at least. It looks easiest to eliminate y. And I can multiply this equation by 2 and then just add it to that one. Poof, y is gone. I can multiply this one by 4 and add it to that one. Y would be gone then as well. So it looks like it's easier to me to eliminate y. So that's where I'm going to start. First, I'm going to letter these equations so I can talk about them and you'll know which one I'm talking about. I'm going to start off by multiplying equation B by 2, and that's going to set up an elimination of y with equation A. So our first step here is we're going to just multiply equation B by 2. And we'll get 10x minus 4y minus 6z is 50. And now we can add this equation to equation A, and that'll eliminate y. So this will just be, you know what, I'm going to letter this equation as well. Equation A plus equation D, 3x plus 10x is 13x. 4y minus 4y, no more y's. 5z minus 6z gives us minus z. Minus 3 plus 50 is 47. We'll call that equation E. Equation E still has two variables. Eliminated one variable, we had three. That leaves 2. Now what? I can't figure out what x or z is. If only I had another equation that just had x and z, then I'd have a system of two linear equations with two unknowns, and I'd be able to handle that. We have lots of good strategies for that. So I have one equation. If I can find one more equation that has just x and z, I can use that together with e, and we can figure out what x and z are. I can get another equation with just x and z. I can take c right here, this equation, and set up an elimination with a, eliminate y again. If I eliminate y from these two equations, then we'll be all set. We're going to multiply this equation by 4 to set up that elimination. So we start off with 4 times equation c, and we'll get 36x minus 4y plus 16z. Equals negative 48. We're just multiplying equation C there by 4, and that'll give us equation F. And we're going to take F and add it to A. When we add A and F, the Y is going to eliminate. A plus F, 3X plus 36X, 39X, 4Y minus 4Y, no more Y. 5Z plus 16Z, 21z minus 3 minus 48 is minus 51. We're calling that equation G. And now we have a system of two linear equations with two unknowns. Equation E and equation G. Together, they're both linear equations, and they only have x and z, no y in sight. So now we'll set up an elimination just with these two. I'm going to multiply equation E here, multiply that by negative 3. Set up elimination of x. Negative 3 times E gives us minus 39x plus 3z equals, multiply this by 3. See, 3 times, let's see, 3 times 40 is 120. 3 times 7 is 21. Add those together, you get a little 141. It's multiplying by a negative 3 here, so this is minus 141. Of course, we'll call that H. And now we've set up our elimination here. We're going to add equations G and H. X's eliminate, 21z plus 3z gives us 24z. Minus 51 minus 141 is minus 192. And now we can find z. Divide both sides here by 24. I mean, I could start off just by dividing both sides by 2. I'll get 12z equals negative 96. Divide 12 into negative 96, we get z is negative 8. Now I can take that negative 8 and put it back in up here to figure out what x is. We have 13x minus the negative 8, that's plus 8, is 47. 13x is 39. X is 3. So now I've got x, I've got z. Now all we have to do is figure out y. I'm going to come back up here and use this equation right here to figure out what y is. Put in x and z, and we'll have, putting them in here, 3 times 9 gives us 27 minus y plus 4 times a negative 8 is minus 32 is negative 12. Simplify this a little bit. Minus y minus 5 is negative 12. That gives us minus y is minus 7, so y is 7. All right, let's check. Let's check. It's a big complicated problem. We did a lot of algebra there. We can check this by substituting all three of these into each of these equations, and let's see if it works. 3 times 3 is 9, plus 4 times 7 is 28, and then 5 times minus 8 is minus 40. 9 plus 28 is 37, minus 40, that's negative 3. Try the next equation. 5 times 3 is 15, minus 2 times 7 is minus 14. Minus 3 times minus 8 is plus 24. 15 minus 14 is 1, 1 plus 24, 25. 9 times x, 9 times 3 is 27, minus 7 plus 4 times minus 8, that's minus 32. 27 minus 7 is 20, minus 32, that gives us minus 12. It all works out, so we have found our solutions. As you imagine, this is just the tip of the iceberg. We can go on. We've got a system of three linear equations with three unknowns. We could try 4, we could try 5, we could try 6, and we could do this same sort of thing. We use these same sorts of strategies that we used with a system of two linear equations with two variables. Same things can happen. We can have just one solution, we can have zero solutions, we can have infinitely many solutions. Of course, I don't think you're real excited about trying this with 4, 5, or 6 variables. Imagine trying it with 100 variables, or 1,000, or 1,000,000 equations with 1,000,000 unknowns. Well, mathematicians and computer scientists have developed answers for that too. And you'll learn all about those methods when you study linear algebra. It's a big, rich subject that's a lot more fascinating than the simple name implies.